Well, well, quite the mess you've made here. I'm Malady, and you're...
She steps forward, grabs you behind the neck with alarming strength, and pulls you close. She sniffs twice, her nose at your ear, then bites, piercing the lobe with a needle-sharp fang. She releases you and grins, running tongue over teeth.
God-woken. My mother certainly thought so. I didn't hurt you, did I?
She leans back. Looks you over and smokes.
So, Godwoken, you're what gets some of us out of bed each morning. What do you make of that? Well, first things first.
She peers at you closely, a knowing squint in her eye.
Tell me, which of those little gods did you meet? And what did they teach you? That it is, and if you want to take my boat off this island, you'll consider me a privileged party. Believe it or not, I'm here to help you. So? They're free to smite me where I stand if I'm wrong.
She cocks her head and smiles. Her eyes go wide.
Go on then. Show me what he taught you. Ah, like that. Right, hold on then.
She takes you by the shoulders and gestures for you to do the same to her. She closes her eyes and a warm, soothing sensation runs from her hands into your body. Suddenly, you feel the familiar swell of source within you.
Perfect. You really are Godwoken. I'm happy. How unbecoming. Come then, we set sail, your destiny awaits, etc. You'll have to ask the Meister about that. She's dying to meet you.
Malady beckons you to the boat.
After you, darling. Boat first, questions later. As you wish.
Found something.
Mercy. Athena the Brave. You are daring indeed to enter my domain. As well you should. I'm an assassin of ants and crucifier of crickets. All rodents bow before me. So do lesser beasts, like humans, for instance. My title is bestowed upon me by the King of All Rats in honor of my renowned achievements.
She waxes on at length regarding her wartime exploits, describing feats no rat you've ever seen could actually perform.
And thus I brought Moriander to his knees, and that was all before noontime.
To your surprise, the rat listens intently as you recount your time in Fort Joy and your escape into the Hollow Marshes.
Oh, my friend, you are an adventure after my own heart. I have heard many stories in my day, but none as exciting as this. May I ask you a favor, perhaps? I want to know more. More. Return to me when you have a chance and share your adventures. I want to hear about every spell cast and cliffside scaled, every chest pillaged and every sword swung. But if you are to return, I need to make sure you remain in one piece. So, let me share another morsel of information I've picked up on my travels. The levers in here are cursed. Best not to touch them unless you bless them somehow, lest they infect you with their torment. Now hurry back. I can't wait to hear if your ventures can hold a candle to the other. I mean, to my own.
Knowing the reputation of Bracchus Rex, we should tread gingerly. This contraption.
Before you stands an ancient shrine, runes carved deep into its rock. The runes are in no language you understand or recognize. The shrine seems completely inert. You feel the source inside you swell up, filling your chest, yearning to be free. Your power flows from your chest and into your hands, green tendrils of power slithering from your fingertips across the shrine. The shrine starts to vibrate and glow, slabs of stone gliding across each other as it begins to open.
Good find.
His Most Gracious Highness, Bracchus Rex.
Yes.
The menacing skeletal guardian looks at you wearily, then yawns.
So you dare defy the will of Bracchus Rex, prepare to die, and so on and so forth. Let's get this over with. I was a loyal servant of the Source King. I carry out his will in death, as in life, and all that sort of thing. Now, can we get down to the fighting? I was enjoying a lovely dirt nap before you helped those heretical pigs. It's dark and dirty, though still a paradise of a sort. I cannot say what nightmares or delights await the fully dead. In a few moments, I dare say you will discover that information firsthand.
She moans impatiently and taps her bony foot.
Yes, yes, I know he's dead. I am still obligated to perform his wishes. He may not live, but the threat of his curse hangs over me. It is as you say. In any case, no curse could possibly be worse than this droning drivel. Be on your...
The guardian chokes on her words, as if strangled by an invisible hand.
Thank you.
blade. I gather you're guarding quite the prize.
I nearly took you for a magister and put a blade through you. That was close.
She looks at you with wet...
Good to see you. You take care now. And don't you let me down.
Bolted on there tight, ain't it?
It's bolted on there tight, ain't it?
Who in their right mind would think of a thing like this?
She looks at you with wet eyes and manages a wink before returning to her work.
Good to see you.
The shrine depicts Lucy and the Divine, avatar of the... Again. The cub looks sadder than...
I figured it was only a matter of time. I'm ready to pay the price. That's not for me to say. If you must kill me, then kill me. No. I owe Alexander everything. If I die, I die. At least I do so with a clear conscience.
Let's go. Malady grabs the vessel with two hands and pushes it into the water. She hops on board behind you.
Godwoken. Wait till she finds out.
Salty water mists your face. Your skin prickles in bright, warm sunlight. The boat bobs forward through the water, and Fort Joy shrinks behind you.
Tired but victorious, the party made for the Lady Vengeance. The horrors of Fort Joy behind them. They arrived as sorcerers. They left as godwoken. The fate of this godforsaken world now rested on their shoulders. Or at least, on the shoulders of one of them.
Interesting. Quirkus,
a light sea breeze kisses your cheek and carries away the smell of blood wafting up from the deck. In the distance, Fort Joy looms.
A hard-fought freedom, sure. But if spilling blood is bad, it shouldn't be so agreeable.
Bad luck to let the dead linger aboard. As soon as we get moving, we ought to clear the deck.
Don't stand between a prince and his principles. The Magisters learned that the hard way. Onward now. The sooner Fort Joy disappears from the horizon, the better. Perhaps the Seekers need help manning the ship.
Well, well, this is a fine sight. Utterly barbaric, of course, destroying a tree and turning it into a boat. Grotesque, but, well, look at it, Quirkus. A floating nest! Surrounded on all sides by salt water, pure poison to a tree's root. The great acorn could never reach us out here. Well, yes, of course we'll continue our research, Quirkus. We're not monsters. Still, I must admit, you were right about the shield. It proved to be more than adequate. No. Yes, it... It seems our shield is still here, Quirkus. How does something so large and ungainly sneak up on a person? You give the giants too much credit, Quirkus. I think the salty air has addled your mind. It has certainly been useful, but elegant, kind, surprisingly attractive. No, we have no time for your fawning. We may be safe, but the world is not. Come, we must return to our research.